31 male. Found out my fiancé cheated during her 30 female bachelorette party, planning on leaving. Not sure how to describe it, but I was snooping around the house last night and saw her phone ticket off, which turned up to be a message from her friends about the party. I stayed up late like one of those stalkers you see on television, keeping an eye on the internet and her Facebook conversations with her friends, and I learned that she had cheated at her bachelorette celebration. No, I'm not talking about getting a strip tease or anything like that, which is okay since it's a bachelorette party, but rather she really gave a stripper a blowjob and ended up going home with another guy that night. However, her Facebook chat with this other guy consisted mostly of an interchange along the lines of "had a beautiful time" and "it was nice to meet you," which was a carryover from the bachelorette party. I did, however, read the messages between her and her friends. They are a small group, and I was able to figure out what she was up to while they were there. Everything seems to be a one-time incident, but I'm a complete and utter disaster. Her alarm will go off in an hour or two, and she'll be on her way to work when she wakes up in an hour or two. It's almost 6 a.m. here. I'm at a loss for what to do since our wedding is scheduled for 3 weeks from now. I'm considering just gathering my stuff when she goes for work and moving out. After all, the apartment is on her family's land, and we had every intention of buying a big house, having children, and getting old there together. I'm having the strong want to throw everything out the window. I'm sitting here, smelling like wine and feeling euphoric, but yet depressed and depressed. Since learning about the events of the last few days, I've become more of a furious depression rather than a sad depression. I haven't shed a tear since learning about everything. Is it okay for me to approach her? Is it better for me to just leave? Is it necessary for me to hear her side of the story? I really want to smack her face in right now, but I'm not in the mood to do anything rational with my feelings. Please lend a hand. Please accept my apologies for any errors. I'm typing from my iPad and I'm not in the greatest of spirits right now. Also, I am European, not English. Edit 1. I've gone through all of the comments, both favorable and bad, and I agree with everything. I wasn't anticipating such a strong response, but I suppose I'll just have to leave it at that. My best guess is that I'll do it when she's at work, but I'm not sure. I instantly feel more at ease, and I like hearing everyone's thoughts and opinions. My decision to stop drinking and engaging in risky behavior has been finalized. I'll make every effort to keep you informed about what's going on. Story 2. Found out GF 23 female, of 4.5 years cheated on me, 23 male. So we started dating in 2017, and she was my first love, and for the most part, everything were going well in our relationship. Now fast forward to the year 2021, and this is when everything started to go awry. She had been preparing to go for her basic combat training BCT with the Air Force in January 2021, when she decided to join for personal reasons that I will not get into. I respected her decision, and she left for a period of 6 months. I stayed at home for the most of her absence, since I didn't want to do anything that would be considered disrespectful of her decision to leave. It all started when I went out with some friends to a neighboring pub one night. In May, to give you some perspective, it was simply a lad's night out, nothing too exciting. But when she, former girlfriend, found out, she freaked out, assumed the worst and ended our relationship. It has been a month since she has returned home, and it is now the month of June. Her search for me results with us fixing things as soon as she returns, which is exactly what I anticipated. We had a strong link. When we had disputes, I always gave her space, and as time passed, we would simply get over them and go on with our relationship. The night after she returned from her training, she informs me that we must talk, and she is shouting and weeping at this point in the conversation. She tells me, and these are the precise words she used to say it. Although her exact words were, "I met someone over there that I found interesting. I remember them to this day. And I asked her if she had slept with him or anything because she was crying, and she said no, saying she could never cheat or do that type of stuff. So I took her word for it and didn't think much of it because I knew she had always been an honest person. Now fast forward to December 11, 2021, and one night I got a message from the 18-year-old man she had told me about, and I couldn't believe what I was hearing. It turns out that she did sleep with him, and that they had a relationship for the 1 or 2 months that she was away at her training, and that she had been talking to this guy ever since she got back. So for 5 months she had been talking to this guy, and yes, she has only talked to him over the phone, because the guy is stationed in another country, because he is stationed in another country. My subsequent days are made much worse when I discover that they had intended to be married and start a new life together. As any reasonable person would do, I lose my cool and tell her we're done. So I'm stuck in the middle and perplexed. I want to repair things and forget the past, but the fact that she has to choose makes everything that much more difficult. What I need is some direction, not simply platitudes such as "you deserve better," but genuine advice. The reason for doing this now is because I don't want time to pass and I'll wonder, what if we corrected things? Edit. I'm very aware of how terrible this seems on my end, and I'm well aware that it probably is. This lady has already made up her mind, and I would like it if she had the confidence to tell me so in person so I can have some form of closure and know that things will never work and that I would never have to ask myself that question again. Story 3. Just found out wife cheated. Let me begin by saying that my wife and I have been experiencing a serious communication breakdown for quite some time. I had a strong suspicion she was snooping around, but it wasn't until this weekend that I found out. It annoys me that she has been providing me information on a drip feed basis. Our 2-day deliberation and lamentation about what went wrong was a terrific experience. I can't say that I blame her for seeking attention from someone else, since I wasn't providing her with what she needed at the time. It had been a pleasant 2 days of reconnection, but there was still that look in her eyes that I couldn't shake. I tried all I could to get rid of it. She then informed me that she had told me more than she had first led me to think, which I found surprising. She said it was just texting and flirting, but then admitted she made out with him and that he touched her. It's not funny how much I want to put my faith in her. However, after hearing further facts, it seemed that the previous 2 days of chatting and being honest had been for nothing, as she was still essentially lying in order to not hurt me anymore, as she said. But I can't seem to shake these annoying mental movies from my brain. We've been intimate again since it happened, and I truly want to be with her, but I don't think I'll be able to really enjoy it this time. I'm under immense pressure to be so good that she won't leave me for someone better, and my thoughts race through my head whenever we're together in private. I just get a bad feeling every now and again, like if I don't know what I'm talking about. As a result, we're going to begin therapy, and I'm truly hoping to reconcile with her and go on, since she means so much to me, as well as for the sake of our child. The purpose of this whole communication is unclear to me, but I assume the only aim was to get this nonsense down on paper. Thank you in advance for any advice or words of support you might provide me. Although I may not agree with some of you, I would want to express my appreciation to everyone who has answered. It is really appreciated that you took the time out of your day to share your thoughts and ideas with us. I'm well aware that I'm bad at this, but it's my way of telling people how much I value their friendship. As a result, thank you all so much for helping me with something I'd forgotten how to do for myself, much alone strangers.